You know that Taylor shares a function, and that is sufficient if your function is analytic. If your function is not analytic at a couple of points, so only analytic in some angles, we will need a series containing also negative powers. Such a series is called the Lorentz series. You will learn exactly what it is in this video. So what's the case? We have some set zero, some isolated singularity. We have already R1 and R2. So R1 and R2. And now your f of z is analytic in the region between the R1 and the R2. So the circle with the circles are the red circles, it's already R1 and R2. And in between our f of z is analytic. Suppose now C is the yellow contour, some positively oriented, simple, closed contour. So you do not have self-intersections, so no edge like that. You have to be closed, of course. And you go counterclockwise, that's what we call positively oriented. So you see you can easily draw it in this picture, some C around it. Then we can expand our function f of z. We have some part which is similar to what we had for our analytic function with positive powers in z minus z zero, but now because we have this singularity inside, so we have an annulus, so that means that we also need a part with negative powers, bn divided by z minus z zero to the power n. This second part is called the principal part of the Lorentz series. Now the theorem tells us how to find the coefficients, the an for n from 0, 1, 2, etc. So from the positive part, from the positive powers in z minus z zero, that's just the same as we had for Taylor series. Now the bn becomes a bit difficult, different, but quite similar. We only get a minus n over here instead of plus n, and now n runs from 1, 2, 3, etc. So we will not prove it yet in this video. Let's just rewrite a bit. This is one way to write our f of z. So what we can do? Well, we can use an m as our summation variable as well for the second part. And then we set m equals minus n. Then the n runs from minus 1 to minus infinity. We get the b of minus n over here. And it set minus z zero to the power of minus n over there. So 1 over z minus z zero to the power of minus n is, of course, z minus z zero, so we can simplify a bit and change the summation sign. That doesn't matter whether you sum from minus 1 to minus infinity or from minus infinity to minus 1, you get the same result. And we can write the expression for the b minus n, that means we have to plug in a minus n over here, so we get this expression over here for n equals minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. But then you'll see that the expression for the b minus n is exactly the same as the expression for the an. And this part looks exactly the same as this part. So we can take them together. So we define cn as the an for n positive and as b minus n for n negative. So we have the cn for all n's. And then our an consists of the an plus the part with the b minus n. But now for n positive, the an are just cn, and for the n negative, the cn equals the b minus n. So that means that we can write our alphabet as one sum. So that is what the Lorentz series is. It's a Taylor series, but now it also contains a principal part with all kinds of negative powers. You still might wonder why this is true. I might wonder how to find Lorentz series of different functions. Well, that's all subject of our next videos.